to the importance of having a president who understands the power of diplomacy and understands the strength that rests in understanding the significance of diplomacy and strengthening alliances. This is an incredible day.
Welcome back to the program. Dana Loesch with you. I remember there was one time in, I think it was biology, because history was easy, but I had to write something about the cell or some kind of paper, and I just was done writing about it. But I had a word count that I had to meet. And towards the end of the paper, I was just throwing all kinds of word webs out there, trying to just stretch it as much as possible. Well, and the mitochondria, as one would know of mitochondria, is the powerhouse or the thing that powers the house of the mitochondria, the cell in which the mitochondria is in. And I just constructed this like Rube Goldberg sentence diagram so I could get all the way to the finish line of the word count. Now, that was just one paper when I was in junior high. This is her every day. That's Kamala Harris every single time. She sees a microphone and she just, there's like something that happens in her mind where she just has to talk and she doesn't wind down. And Joe Biden, if we can throw, we don't have to play it again, but if we could throw it back up there, Joe Biden standing next to her, his chin disappeared into his collar. I don't know what happened. It like his chin slid all the way down his neck into his collar. And he just, she's talking and he's looking at her like, the hell? And she keeps going. And then he just, he is that profile. He just looks like, oh my gosh. I think he just fell asleep standing up is what I think happened. But his face is literally all of us. And at one point he kind of turns and looks and just like, oh.
I think he may have walked on that plane just to escape.
He probably did. Like he's looking at her now. If you're not watching the simulcast, let me voice act it. And, you know, things that stuff.
This particular Biden body double looks really good, though.
It's so perfect.
It looks convincing.
You think that's a body double?
It's very convincing. Look at that.
Can
little,
they trim? Can like I just point out something?
Small mullet.
Please, for the love of all things holy, will you trim whatever fuzz is at his nape?
He's going for a mullet.
His hair, it's not a mullet yet.
He's going for it.
But it's like sticking out at his nape.
You can't just all of a sudden just poof out a mullet. You
Which, by
start
the way,
somewhere.
I hate that word, nape. On Attack on Titan, they always talked about that all the time. Go for the nape. Sorry, you have to know it. But I hate that word. But anyway, it sticks out like I can see things under it. Juan, if you do not screen cap what you just have in the monitor right there, I'll never forgive you. Wait till he turns, and then you're going to see some
right
red
here.
In between the hair. And I mean, you can see it sticking out.
There it is.
It's sticking out.
It's kind of like an umbrella.
Right there. Oh, my gosh. Like, cut that.
It's his mullet.
Why would you not trim it? Who's what? You know what? I can tell Jill hates him. Because if my husband went out with his hair looking like that, I would hold him down like I was wrestling a pig. And I would chop that off the end of his nape. I would cut that off. That's like duck fluff sticking off the ass of a duck. That's what it is. It's duck fluff. Quack, quack. I mean, my gosh.
It's like an awning made of mullet.
It's not even a proper mullet
because
you can see underneath it. It's just sticking out. Who allows the man to do this?
You can see a streetlight from across the road
yeah.
there, right in between.
Why does Jill allow her man to go and do? I'm going to tell you something. No self-respecting woman, no good, decent woman allows her man to go out with his hair looking like this. None. You can always tell in a couple if the woman hates the man, because if the man has hair like this and that woman is not giving him grief for it, she hates him. Hates him. That's how you can tell. There's no way. I'd bristle him down. I'd cut it off. I'd shave it off while he's sleeping. There's no way. Because it's also a reflection of you, ladies, right? Come on, ladies, be honest about it. You look at his hair as an extension of your hair, so it has to look nice, you know? And if it don't look nice, then you don't look nice, and that's problems. But that's duck fluff. I can't get over this. The leader of the free, well, you know,
he's
for all intents and purposes, leader of the free world. And he's got duck fluff hanging off the back of his neck. And then you got, you know, Willie Brown's ex-girlfriend out there word salading. I just can't. This is like Dumb and Dumber, but in real life. Our pets' heads are falling off. I mean, it's just so bad. Oh my gosh, I can't get over that. Cut that. Trim it. It's not hard. Good heavens. So neither of them spoke well. Let's just put it like this. They get them on the tarmac, and not a single one of them met the challenge of speaking well. So you just heard her. Which one is he? Is three the one where he's there? Is that him talking?
I think so.
Okay, let's play. That's a press conference. What? Because didn't he talk on the tarmac too? And it was horribly bad. I mean, it was so bad I can't even differentiate anymore. Both of them were just like.
We did play cut five. That was from the tarmac too, I think, right?
Oh my gosh. Let's look at this one. Okay, yeah. Okay, so this is where he's talking about the assassination of that Hamas, the Hamas's leader, Ismail Haniyeh, who's dead now. And he's talking about a Gazan ceasefire deal. Barely. He's barely talking. Listen.
I'm very concerned about it. I had a very direct meeting with Prime Minister today, and very direct. We have the basis for a ceasefire. You should move on it, and they should move on it now. Pardon me? It's not helped.
It just is so weird. It's so weird. No energy. It's so weird. Kane and I were talking about the time when they caught Trump on the tarmac. He was leaving it's like a political rally.
Yeah.
And someone just told him that Ginsburg kicked the bucket, Ruth Bader Ginsburg. And he was like, oh, I didn't know that. And it was like a movie scene. And Elton John was playing in the background, not like the person, but like the song was playing in the background. What was it, Candle in the Wind?
Yeah, yeah. And then he said something just really poignant and nice. And
it was like
away.
That was the score of it. It was fascinating. But kind of the difference, the tarmac measure. They just look both so bad, guys. Oh, my word. Now, I think with Kamala Harris, I don't know that a VP pick has ever been more important than it is for her. I mean, you guys have seen, well, you've heard her try to talk. You've seen her try to talk. None of it's good. It's all. But I think that whoever she picks, they have got to make her look better. They've got to make her look better. And I don't know who that's going to be. If it's going to be somebody like Josh Shapiro, if it's going to be an Andy Beshear, and I was telling you earlier that Shapiro cleared his schedule out, and I wrote a piece about it at Chapter and Verse. He cleared out his schedule, and they also had, who I think Beshear did too, and then you had a number of other, Buttigieg, Beshear, Tim Walz, Josh Shapiro all cleared their schedules. So it could be a four-way fight. It could be her campaign, like, faking everybody out. But I think Shapiro might be her best bet, particularly since Democrats have sort of stepped in it with the Jewish community because they've been trying to appease Dear Bornistan. So I just feel like that may be her best bet. And also, Andy Beshear just looks like a FUD. He does. And Tim Walz isn't any better. He literally is a FUD. And then, well, I'm not even going to talk about the guy who's like the love child of Bob the Builder and Howdy Doody. We're not going to have that conversation. Good heavens. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.